Hey you guys, this is Raphael from ShilohRelics.com. I hope you're each safe. I hope you're each healthy. I hope things are going your direction because you deserve it. And thank you again for taking the time to be with me today. I am so thankful for each one of you. We've had so many kind words, so many people just, I'm so thankful for you guys. Sometimes even as many words as I have, I don't know what to say thank you. I appreciate you guys. I hope that you enjoy these. Thank you for sharing them. Thank you for posting on them. Thank you for liking them. Today we're going to talk about one of the, if a gun can be pretty, this is one of the most attractive guns that the U.S. military ever made, and I think they're pretty. They are officially known as the U.S. Model 1841 rifle. They made them at several different places. The nickname that these guns have has always stuck with them. They're referred to as the Mississippi rifle. And not because they were made in Mississippi, but because during the Mexican War, the war between the U.S. and Mexico, they were used by a regiment of Mississippians, and they were under the command of Jefferson Davis, who would go on to be the president of the Confederacy. They used them tremendously well, and the nickname just stuck, the Mississippi Rifle. And so that's what we've always referred to them. They're a gun that stayed in service a long time. These guns were made, they're Model 1841, but they were made during the 1840s on up into the early 1850s. And they used them well into the Civil War and after because they were a really quality gun. During the early days, when they left the factory originally, they were 54 caliber. 54 caliber, 33 inch barrel, and this one is in the original configuration. And that's important because a lot of them were taken back into the arsenals and converted. In 1855, that same Jefferson Davis was Secretary of War and was one of the guys that helped standardize a lot of the guns to 58 caliber. So these guns went back into the arsenals, were bored out that extra .04, and so they could use a more standardized cartridge. These, and this one is in the original 54 caliber, which is neat. I love the alterations, and I like these guns because there is so much variation. I bought a collection one time and had 126 of these in one collection. And I've got a picture somewhere of them all laid out across my garage when I was trying to go through and figure out what have I done. It's going to take me forever. I thought I'm never going to be able to sell that many of the same kind of rifle, but they had all of those little different variations. It took me about 8 months, so I was excited. We at the time I had my partner Larry Hicklin was he's a little bit more thrifty than I am, and he wouldn't buy it unless it was a guaranteed moneymaker. Which I guess is why he's retired and I'm still working. Smart guy, but I told him that they were a certain amount. And I got up there and they were a lot more. So I just came up with the extra money and bought the thing. And I told him a couple of years later, I was like, you remember that collection? It was a little bit more than we thought it was going to be. But it worked out well. 8 months, 126 guns. That's a lot. Back to the guns. This one is kind of interesting because it's one of the ones that was made in Windsor, Vermont. Windsor, Vermont. They were made from 1845 to 1848 at this company. This company is the Robbins, Kendall, and Lawrence Company. They made about 10,000 of them, and 10,000 was of the total production of the 1841 rifle, the Mississippi rifle, was 60,296 according to the records. So they did about 1/6 of them. But the marking is kind of cool, because Robbins, Kendall, and Lawrence were completely different cats. Robbins was the money. Lawrence was the engineer. He's the guy. And actually, if you hear R.S. Lawrence, that name's going to ring a bell, especially if you own a Sharps carbine, because his name is on every one of those sight bases that are put on Sharps carbines and rifles. R.S. Lawrence. So that one ought to trigger a thing. The other cat, Kendall, was a gunsmith, and his name was Nicanor Kinder. Say that one 12 times fast. Nicanor Kendall, he was the other cat. And he didn't stay long. Robbins and Lawrence stayed in business afterwards, but this is their main contract. The guns are visually beautiful because they use a lot of brass. You've got brass for the trigger guard, you've got brass for the barrel bands, you've got brass for the nose cap, you've got the brass for the butt plate, and they've got one thing that's a huge piece of brass, and that's this. It's called a patch box, and it flips open to reveal that, and it's a place where you could carry your gun tool. You see gun tools a lot. You also see a little extra nipple, which is what allows the spark from the percussion cap to get down into the barrel to fire it. And they just use a ton of brass on them, so they're attractive. This one is for sale as of today on ShilohRelics.com. You can go on there. You can see pictures of it. And if you want to see a few of those variations, I've got a few, because they did a lot of variations. They did them, Colt did them, Harper's Ferry did some of them. They were done for states. New Hampshire had one, New York had one. There's a lot of variation in them. It's something neat to look and read about. I've got several of them on there because I buy what I like, because I've learned over the years, if you like it, somebody else will like it. It might take a while to find that person, but generally if one person likes it, another one will. I hope that you guys are okay. I hope that in today's crazy world that you make the decision to be kind. Don't let the anger get the best of you. That's the easy way out. Do the right thing, because the right thing will always take you to the right place eventually. Don't feel like it sometimes, but it always will. I hope that you guys are safe. Remember to hug your family, because the family is something that you can't replace. Everything else can be replaced, but not a family. I love you guys, and I'll catch you next time.